Hi guys, it's me, Stamp Cat. I'm back with another stamp collecting video, and obviously the theme of this episode is Pokémon! As you probably know, Pokémon started out as a video game which was released in the mid to late 90s. That's how I got into it, so I played those first games, Pokémon Red and Blue, and I've been obsessed ever since. Pokémon's basically the thematic collection of my entire life. After the games were such a hit, the Pokémon franchise totally exploded. Now it includes the anime series, the Pokémon trading card game, which is another huge collectible item as well, and tons of Pokémon paraphernalia, so obviously there's plushies, little figurine toys, and then fan art, which I have a lot of here, and Pokemon postage stamps, which is what I'm gonna be showing you guys today. The Pokemon stamps that I'm collecting currently are all from Japan. The first one that I want to show you is, it's a souvenir sheet. These stamps were first issued in 2005. It is the first issue of the Animation Heroes and Heroines series. And it's also the first souvenir sheet that Japan issued to be entirely composed of animation stamps. Japan had released stamps with anime characters before this, but they were bundled together in this science, technology, and animation. So it would have some animation stamps, but sprinkled in with other like technological inventions. So this is the first one that highlighted an entire anime series just on its own. So the stamps include Pikachu on a little Pokeball, Charizard, Mew, Rayquaza, and Munchlax. And then the graphic to the side is a scene from the anime. So we have Ash, Brock, Mei, and her little sister, her little brother Max there. So that's my souvenir sheet. The other Pokemon stamps that I have, they are all Pikachu, and they are all postally used, issued by Japan as well. So this is my bundle of Pikachu stamps here. These were all issued in 2011, basically to commemorate the Phila Nippon World Stamp Exhibition. So the Phila stands for philately or philatelic. Nippon is another name for Japan. And I'll just show you a couple of these. These two were issued at the beginning of the year in January 2011 as a hype or whatever in preparation for the convention coming up. The other two types that I have, those were issued when the convention was taking place. So that was in July of that year, 2011. What I love about these is that holographic effect that they added here. So if you look at the words at the top here, the Philanip on 2011. I love that like shiny holographic thing that they added. That's one of my favorite features of these. Couple other things that I love about these. Some of them are, you might have heard the term soft on the nose. My favorite is this one. It is actually soft on the Pokeball. Whoever stamped this at the post office took a little bit of time to appreciate this stamp. They lined up their mark exactly with the Pokeball and stamped it on there. The other one that I have that's, you can see the entire postmark is right here. And I tried to look into where those postmarks were from, but I didn't have too much luck. So a postmark I know will include the date and then place that the stamp or letter was mailed from. I think the top number might be the year. So Japan does their years a little bit differently. They would count by year that the emperor has been in reign. I looked up that 23 would correspond to 2011. So that would make sense for the year of this stamp. But then there are four other numbers on here, and I don't know what's the month and what's the day and what are these other numbers. And obviously I can't read the Japanese writing. So if anyone can help me out, that would be great. These stamps too, they were all issued as part of a set. So it wasn't just Pikachu by itself. I got some others that were released as part of the set for the Phila Nippon exhibition as well, which I'll show you here. We have Astro Boy, Doraemon, which are some other popular anime shows. And then there's this stamp here that was the mascot for Phila Nippon convention. At first I thought that one doesn't really fit in with the other ones. Like, what is this stamp? So this picture is actually considered by some to be Japan's first ever manga. So it is a picture from some scrolls from the 12th to 13th century. And the scrolls depict only in pictures animals and people going about their lives doing various things, or like human-like things. So that's considered by some to be the oldest manga, or the first ever manga. So I want to share with you guys two really interesting pieces of news that have to do with Pokemon and the mail system. Japan Japan has actually released Pokemon ambassadors to represent certain cities or regions. One of them is the Takamatsu region of Japan. This area is famous for its udon noodles, and the Japanese name for Slowpoke is Yadon. I'm probably pronouncing this wrong, but basically the Japanese name of Slowpoke is similar to udon, so he is the mascot for this area. It is in the Kagawa prefecture, and they have a mailbox that has Slowpoke on it, enjoying some udon. There is a mail truck that has the Slowpoke on it as well, and a cancel mark that is available at the post office for the rest of this year. If I was able to travel, I would definitely consider going to Japan just to check out this region and eat all the udon noodles and like stamp a bunch of stationery and mail it in the Slowpoke mailbox. The second piece of news that I have for you is that Australia is actually releasing some Pokemon stamps this year to celebrate the 25th anniversary of Pokemon. So this was released in the Australia Post News Bulletin. Here's a little snapshot of what the stamps could look like. Now, the only thing that I found a little bit disappointing is I think the actual Pokemon stamps are actually Cinderella's. So if the stamps look exactly like what's pictured here, it doesn't look like the ones with Pokemon can actually go in the mail on their own. So I don't see any country name or indication of a price value for postage on the stamps. It looks like just the piece with the balloons is the one that you would put on a letter to mail it. I feel like people could just take this booklet, and if they were gonna use it to mail it, rip off the Pokemon part and give it to their kid, which is probably what it's actually for, and possibly not mail it through the mail. So I'm not sure if I would collect these. I'm definitely intrigued, but again, I wish that the stamp was actually the Pokemon. It looks more like this is kind of like a Cinderella. But it's still cool, and this news just came out within a week or so ago. Up and coming postal news, you guys. Okay, that's all that I have to say for this video. I hope you enjoyed, especially if you're a fellow Pokemon fan as well. Stay tuned for more, and as always, stay curious. Bye!